It was a day that began like any other, until that little nuclear misunderstanding. So now, there are only six of us. Somehow, each of us found our way to this farm. Now all we have to do is rebuild society.
I did what you said. I checked on the squash crop.
This doesn't look like any squash I've ever seen.
It's obviously some sort of mutation.
We planted an entire acre of these. Frederick, do you think they're safe to eat?
Yes.
I know why they turned out this way. They're like mood squash.
Mood squash?
Yeah, you know, like they have different shapes and colors depending on how they're feeling. Like this is a happy squash. This is an angry squash. Aw, this one's sad.
Suzanne?
Yes?
You're an idiot.
Now wait just a pretty minute here. I wouldn't be so quick to dismiss Suzanne. Now, I agree that on the surface, her idea may seem a little strange, but, well, take it from me, someone who's been homeless all over this great land of ours. I've been a lot of places, met a lot of people, rooted through many a trash can. And if there's one thing I've learned in all my travels, it's that when you start to talk to a group of people, you'd better have at least a vague notion of what it is you're going to say. Because if you don't, you'll just try their patience as you ramble on and on and on.
Shut up!
Well, all I know is that when these squash ripen up, I'm sure they'll be quite tasty. Say, how does Squash Alice sound to everyone?
Something I wanted to do for a long time.
I'm there. Count me in.
Does anyone know how long it takes mutant squash to ripen?
3 days.
Where's Suzanne?
Probably sleeping in. She was up all night singing to herself.
If you ask me, Suzanne has been acting a little peculiar of late.
Morning, Suzanne. How are you? Really good, thanks.
Suzanne, that was quite a fall you took. Are you okay?
I'm like a cat. 7 lives. Always land on my head.
Well, why don't you just sit down? I'll get you some coffee. You missed the chair, dear.
Huh. I've been doing that a lot lately.
Suzanne, I'm a little bit worried about this clumsiness problem you're having. And a little pissed.
I'm sorry. I get this way sometimes. It's just one of those things you get when you have a thing and you get that way, you know? Well, I'm full. If anybody wants me, I'll be up in my room. I'm okay. Still okay. Ow.
Well, it couldn't be any clearer. All the symptoms are there. Klutziness, lack of sleep, loss of appetite. It points to only one thing.
Yeast infection?
No. Our Suzanne is in love.
Alice is right. Look, Suzanne's drawn a heart in the oatmeal. Oh, she's got it bad.
Well, it was bound to happen.
I said she's got it bad, not she's got bad taste. I think this is looking like a guess who's coming to breakfast situation.
What makes you two think it couldn't be me?
You don't think it could be Braddock, do you?
What, Mayor Mushkin over here?
Hey, it's more likely to be me than any of you guys.
Well, I think you men may have overlooked another possibility. I'm not passing judgment here, but Suzanne's affection may be aimed in anotherly gender direction. Toward me. Not that I'd respond, of course. I'd let her down gently with a sensitivity that only two women can share. What?
Here comes Suzanne with the lemonade.
Look, look, I say we pay close attention to her body language. That's how we'll find out who she's infatuated with.
Who's thirsty?
Well, we all are, Suzanne. So why don't you just pick one of us? Whoever you want to serve first. And serve that person first because, oh, say, maybe you like them the most. I don't know, whatever.
Okay.
She's the cream of the crop.
As a matter of taste, to be exact, you're my ideal as a matter of fact. Nothing you can do could make me untrue to my guy, my girl. Nothing you can buy could make me tell a lie to my guy, my gal. I gave my guy my word of honor to be faithful.
God, they're still kissing. This is repulsive.
Curtis, none of us approves of this, but no one's forcing you to look.
Well, it's impossible to ignore when they're practically rubbing your nose in it.
Well, now, that's enough of that. We have far more exciting matters to deal with. Our mutant squash is ripe.
Are you sure, Alice?
I think so. It looks ripe. It's changed colors. It's now a healthy chartreuse. Well, there's only one way to find out. The old squeeze test.
Ma.
Whoa! Mark, did you just hear what I heard?
The mutant squash squeak? Yeah. Let me try one.
Ma.
Whoa!
Did you hear that, Frederick? How can this be?
Radiation.
I don't think so. I think it's just air being released.
Okay, air then.
Mark, what are you doing?
I want to see what it tastes like.
Ugh. Oh, we planted an entire acre of these. We've got to find some use for them.
Well, maybe a headrest? Nope.
I can't watch any more of this. They're completely obscured by that damn tree.
What's going on out there is unnatural. These two are not emotionally equipped to carry on a mature relationship.
We did agree that for the good of the group, we wouldn't get romantically involved with one another.
Well, I suppose the best thing to do would be sit Jack and Suzanne down, explain to them that their relationship is a mistake and that it should stop.
They're coming. Quick, act naturally.
Hi, everybody.
Hi, Suzanne, Jack. Why don't you have a seat? We'd like to talk to you about your relationship.
Oh, good, because there's something we need to tell you.
What?
We've decided to take the plunge.
Yeah, we're moving in together. Well, aren't you going to say something?
Ma.
Whoa!
Move moving in together. Don't you think it's a little sudden?
We've only known each other a short time.
Even you two must see this isn't real.
Oh, everyone, please. Suzanne, Jack, you're both dear, sweet, wonderful people. Fully capable of learning a trade, but love? No.
Well, I know you're all a lot smarter than we are, so I'm sure what you're saying makes a lot of sense. But all I know is whenever I'm with Jack, it's as if all the warmth of the sun has somehow been captured and placed inside my heart.
And all I know is that being with Suzanne makes me feel complete. She fills in pieces of me I didn't even know were missing, and now that I've found her, I can't imagine life without her.
That is so beautiful.
Well, I was skeptical before, but now that I know what you two mean to each other, I feel completely alone and abandoned in a random, hostile universe.
Thanks! Bye.
Jack and Suzanne embarked on a hectic period of house hunting. Eventually, they settled on a secluded loft unit, conveniently located just minutes from both work and leisure activities. In a word, the barn. After Jack and Suzanne had settled in, they invited us over for a housewarming dinner.
Who is it?
It's us, Jack.
Hey, come on in. I'm so glad you could all make it. Honey, company's here.
Be right out.
She's just putting her face on.
Oh, well, I love what you've done with the place. Now, didn't this hay bale used to be over there?
Hi, honey.
Hi, sweetie.
Hey, everybody.
Hi. Here's Suzanne. We brought you over a little housewarming gift.
Oh, you guys. How sweet.
Oh.
Yeah.
It's a vase. Oh. We carved it from the mutant squash.
We finally found a use for them.
Oh, well, thank you. We love it.
Oh, wow.
Well, why don't y'all have a seat? And I'll just put this over here.
Where's your bathroom?
Oh, it's back out the door you just came in, across the yard, and in that big house on the left.
I'll just wait till I get home.
Suzanne, this meal was delicious. I have to get the recipe from you sometime.
Oh, well, I have it around here somewhere.
Found it.
Oops.
Oh, Lucy.
Well, we really should be going.
You got a long ride home.
What a lovely evening. Well, thank you.
I'll walk you guys there.
You gonna come right back?
Well, actually, I thought I might take the cart out for a little spin. You know, I don't want the wheels to rust up.
Yeah, well, I thought we were going to spend some time together this evening, so.
Oh, well, sure, right. Anything you say. It's not like the cart's going anywhere.
Well, thanks again.
Yeah.
Oh, bye-bye.
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 Thanks for coming.
We'll do lunch.
Night.
Oh, I never thought I'd envy Jack and Suzanne, but they're clearly very much in love.
I hope one day I can find what they have.
I'm not sure I've ever actually been in love. But I have been in Saint-Tropez. And this suit costs more than any of you will ever make in your lifetime.
Do you always have to be looking out that window?
What do you want from me? You wanted me to be home, I'm home.
Yeah, but your mind is someplace else. Can't you look at me? Is there something wrong with me?
Right now, yeah. You won't get off my back.
I don't deserve this. Oh, you made me so mad. I...
Suzanne, put that vase down. I'm not kidding. Put that ugly vase down. Put it down.
I can't take this anymore.
She's coming. Quick. Act naturally.
Alice, can I talk to you? Privately?
God forbid we should overhear.
Alice, it's over. I can't go back to him.
Oh, what happened?
He's just so restless. I mean, every night he wheels his cart off somewhere. He doesn't come back for hours. And if I ask him about it, he says I'm smothering him. He just doesn't love me anymore.
Oh, Suzanne, of course he loves you. It's just sometimes it's difficult for men to express their feelings.
Why can't he be as sensitive and as understanding as you are?
Oh, well, I've had a lot of therapy. 6 times a day sometimes.
Suzanne, I need you, baby!
Oh, no. No, I can't go back to him.
Well, then don't.
Suzanne!
This is a mess. Jack, it didn't take you long to fall apart, did it?
I just can't make it without you, babe. Not even 20 minutes. When you're with me, I'm a king. When you're gone, I'm just a joker. Don't leave me again, baby. Don't leave me.
Oh, shit. It's okay, Jack. I'm here, baby.
Suzanne, you gotta believe me when I tell you I need you.
Well, I believe you, Jack. But then why do you get that look in your eyes sometimes like you're a million miles away? It just seems like you'd rather be anyplace else than with me.
It's like there's two Jacks inside of me.
You mean like one Jack, like in a running suit with a Walkman, and like another Jack who's dressed like a jockey, maybe with a big number on his back?
I don't know what they're wearing, baby. It's just, it's like this. When I start feeling penned in, I get crazy like a caged animal. And that's when the cart starts to call to me. It says, hey, Jacko, give me a push. It's time to hit the open road. And then I know I gotta go.
Jackie, you know there's nothing I want more than to see you happy. So if your heart wants to be someplace else, I won't stop you. I mean, it'll kill me, but I won't stop you.
There's never been a woman who could tie me down, baby. Until now. You're like no dumpster I've ever been in.
Let's give it one more try, Jackie.
I love you, baby.
Jack and Suzanne tried to reconcile their differences, but his cart kept beckoning, calling out to the free spirit inside of him. Valiant struggle, but the urge to wander was stronger than even he realized, and soon Jack found that he was fighting a losing battle. The rest of us, painfully aware of what was happening to Jack and Suzanne, realized we had to take decisive action. And so we invited them over for coffee and macaroons.
It was so nice of you guys to have us over.
Yeah, it was really nice of you. It's full moon tonight. Plenty of light. You can really see the stuff on the ground out there.
Jack, why don't you come on over and sit down?
Oh, sure. Sorry, I just needed to stretch a little, that's all.
So, what have you two been up to lately?
Oh, come on, Alice. They're lovebirds. We know what they've been doing. The question is, in which positions?
Well, you know, we've been busy, you know, cleaning, cooking, decorating, collecting twine.
Yeah, like that's really hurting somebody.
Jack, Suzanne, have you seen the new use we found for our mutant squash?
You two kids will really appreciate this. Come on, Jack, have a seat right over there.
Come on.
No, okay, you'll love this. You'll love it. Sit down. Come on. All right. All right.
Ma.
Was that you?
Don't you get it? It's a mutant squash whoopee cushion.
It's funny.
Oh, these squash are useless. We ought to throw out the whole batch.
Yeah, I know just the place. I was wandering around the edge of the field this morning, and I came upon this landfill. It must have been, 50 square yards. Yeah, it went 20, 30 feet straight down, nothing but garbage.
Full moon, good visibility. 50 times 3 square, that's 25, 30, 27,000 cubic feet of virgin landfill. Suzanne, we're finished here for tonight, aren't we?
Yeah, well, I thought we agreed that we'd spend some time together this evening.
We will. We'll spend time. What makes you think we won't spend time? We'll spend time. It's just that I got some people, some guys, some things I need to see out here over this way.
I may have been mistaken. Maybe this wasn't landfill. I mean, I made mistakes before.
No, please, don't go on, Fred. It's been building to this for some time now. Admit it, Jack. Even though part of you wants to spend time with me, an even larger part of you wants to go exploring, I don't think commitment is in your makeup. There's something wild about you, Jack Connors.
Maybe what you're saying is true, Suzanne. I am wild, untamed, raw. But you know something? If I was any different, you wouldn't have fallen in love with me in the first place, and you wouldn't want me now.
Why can't I say that's not true? I release you. Fly. Fly away to your landfill.
Oh, God. These moments are never easy, are they?
I'll never forget you.
I'll always love you, baby.
Although Jack and Suzanne's romance came to an end, no one really believed that they ever stopped loving each other. And sometimes, in the wee hours of the morning, when the wind blows just right off the landfill, you can still hear the strains of a broken heart.
On the next 90210, Brandon's new girlfriend has a past, and on Wednesday night, it comes back to haunt them. Then, has Jake finally met the one woman immune to his charm? Find out on an all-new Melrose Place Wednesday.